both sides of the argument, because you all of you represent one side of the argument and I represent the other. The fact of the matter is that Muslims will not be denied, which is why every day on this channel, on Rahul Kawal's own channel and many, there are Afghani sisters sitting in Delhi, saluting India and saying salam to India and saying how happy we are to be here.
Priyanka and Chaturvedi, the government's strongest counter can be that the
CAA was there particularly because there were minorities who were being persecuted only because they were not Muslims.
The government's strongest counter can be that what's happened in Afghanistan proves why the CAA is not problematic, because not just did we take back Hindus and Sikhs, we also took back those Muslims in Afghanistan who'd been persecuted, proving that the CAA is not just for minorities. We will take back those who are being persecuted regardless of religion. Therefore, it's not necessarily a bad thing. Priyanka Chaturvedi.
Then why do we need to spell out through a CAA, which, by the way, we do not even have the rules in place or the act in place or information in place. And they have also decided a cutoff date, and cutoff date, if we go by the cutoff date for citizenship, then it is not what we are talking about right now. So, you know, this entire argument of CAA and hyphenating it with NRC, etc., was more a political move that the Bharatiya Janata Party did to help in its own politics and its own politics domestically. And we all know that as far as CAA is concerned, not having to spell it out also would get the same results as having spelled it out. It is extremely unfortunate that it became a political tool for the BJP to harp on, which they continue to do. And that is where it becomes unfortunate. And that's why in my opening comment, I said they should stop patting themselves on the back in such a premature fashion and start talking about CAA at a time when every single Indian still awaits rescue. We continue to hear how 150 Indians were detained for some time, how Sikh brothers and sisters were sent back to the Gurudwara and Indian embassy had to bring them back in. So those are, we are endangering our people who are in Afghanistan waiting for a rescue from Indian government by coming up with political comments like this domestically. We are living in a very interconnected world, and for Bharatiya Janata Party to start making
is wrongly directed according to the opposition, because the cutoff here, as Priyanka points out, was 2014. So this debate has actually nothing to do with CAA, because whether you give them status of being Indian nationals or allow them into India has nothing to do with the ambit of the CAA, which was cut off in 2014.
I mean, you know, these are just semantics. The use of word triumphalism, hyphenation, they're just, just big words. They know the truth. They know what politics they did and how they used the Indian Muslim community to as always, to garner votes for themselves, which is what they've been doing all through their lives. Which, I mean, I will not say that about Priyanka, because she's just joined the Shiv Sena. And Shiv Sena has not done that, but I don't know how they stand politically on this later on. And I don't know where Pawan Verma stands, but I know that he has to say something against the BJP, because that's his mandate. But the fact of the matter is,
you're trying to split them up, Shazia. First you said they're three versus one. Now you're trying to rupture opposition unity.
No. But I'm speaking for the CAA as I stand by it. And there has been many clarifications.
Triumphalism
and, you know,
is premature.
These big words, triumphalism, hyphenation, they mean nothing on the ground. And, you know, instead of seeing the 135 that were held back, see what
Except
all has been
the
done.
Most.
I think it's time for all of us
Can
to
I
get together.
Come in?
Instead of always pointing, because people see through this. All the efforts that are being made, be together
Can
with,
I please
with
come
the
in?
Indian government. It doesn't matter which party it is. All the time being critical, using everything as a political tool, and, you know, for your own communal politics, it's very, very unfair. And this is something that has been asked for by so many leaders since the partition.
Okay, so Supriya Srinath, for those who were doubting the government's intentions, what's happened in Afghanistan and the evacuation process shows they brought back Hindus and Sikhs. They also took back Muslims who had worked with the Indian government, who were friends of India, and therefore the government will claim this is evidence of the fact that we weren't discriminating on the basis of religion.
And even before that,
okay, let us speak.
Also, there are special e-visas that I must tell them about, that are for everybody, that are for Muslim women and Muslim men of Afghanistan.
Then the next question, logical question, should be that.
Can I please come in now?
Supriya,
my name is Supriya.
Supriya, please.
Can I please come in? Rahul, that's exactly my point, that if we are going to be the Indians that we are supposed to be, and if we will rescue people from gruesome acts of violence, why have a law and spell out religion and exclude a particular religion? That's exactly the point I'm trying to make. And that's exactly the point everybody is asking today. That if we are going to admit people who are going to be, you know, at the receiving end of grotesque violence, why exclude then? Why should our law say with these people will be excluded? That's the first thing. And the second thing I really want to point out here is, you know, the BJP, its troll army and some of its spokespersons have to stop chest thumping right now. We are in a very, very precarious
nobody
situation.
Nobody says thumping. China is, I think nobody says thumping. But
Pakistan
there is no
is
need
very
to always
actually,
pull
you
down
please,
your government.
Please
and
relax.
All, no,
it's
nobody
my turn
says
to speak.
Thumping.
Let me speak.
And you have your own troll army. You have your own troll army.
Rahul,
this is always breaking the morale
speak,
of this
talk?
Country. And your leader does that. Your leader brings down the morale of the
Rahul,
country,
I was
of
talking.
The army.
Are you there?
And,
can you interview?
Everyone else. So
okay, Shazia, you did. Shazia, this is unfair. Because when Supriya was interrupting, you wanted her to stay silent so that you can make your point. You must surely extend her the same courtesy.
No, I heard her. And she was repeating
you
it.
Just have to see the. Before, you just have to
and
see
and I could
the,
not answer that because she's talking about some troll
army. Can you please
keep
quiet now?
They have as much as troll
okay.
army. And
let her complete. I'm coming back to you, Shazia, in
can
a moment.
Can I please
Supriya,
come in?
Go ahead.
You know, the reality is, check out your social media timelines for the BJP leaders, some of its ministers. Look at how the minorities are being persecuted here in the name of Taliban. Every time you raise petrol prices, you are being told by your troll army to go to Afghanistan. That's what we've come to. Please stop this jingoism. Please stop this chest thumping. It's too premature. We are in a very, very sensitive position. Foreign policy has gone for a complete toss thanks to your government's failure. You know, let's stay united in this, but let's
okay.
please realize
let Shazia respond
wrong,
now
accept it
that this
and,
chest
and,
thumping
and
is premature.
Action.
There are still Indians and people of Indian origin in Afghanistan. Things are volatile and tense, and we should be very careful in our public comments.
You know something, it is... I was just answering that. Sorry, I was not supposed to speak.
No, it was. The question was about the government being triumphalist
okay. I'm just,
and the
yeah.
need to stay away
so,
from chest thumping.
You know, I'm so shocked because, you know, the day Mr. Jaishankar meets his counterparts, and every time there's a high-level meeting, a fake article is circulated, which is tweeted by Supriya Srinath's leader. And we are told about how insecure our country is. That turns out to be a fake news. And the Indian army has to trash it and say that is completely baseless.
No,
now,
we were a part of Doha talks.
We
may not know about it
called,
because our government
our
never took us into confidence.
Being called weak and full of blunders. But, I mean, isn't it sad? Do I need to answer and dignify the
absolutely,
comments made
it
by...
Is. Because you've turned foreign policy into camera
so.
Opportunities.
I don't
photo
think so.
Opportunities.
I think I will not run down my country. No, there is no need
foreign
to do any chest
is not photo op,
and
madam.
Please show me any example of any leader of our party doing that. So don't make up stories. Don't use the
thousands,
words that you think are very impressive.
Thousands.
Because, you know, words without emotion or substantiation of fact mean nothing. You know, it's all about good vocabulary. You have
You've
it,
been
I
caught
have it,
napping on the steering wheel.
Do not do that.
You have
do
no
not
idea
do that.
About
do
foreign
not
policy.
Bring down the country's morale
you can go on
every
and on.
Time.